Hello and welcome to this class of Basics of Macroeconomics. I am your teacher, Mohammad Nadeem Sarwar. Today, we continue our discussion on unemployment and output relationship. This lecture is mainly based from the book Macroeconomics Theories and Policies, Richard T. Fine. In this lecture, we mainly discuss Milton Friedman's theory about natural rate of unemployment and output. Then we discuss the Keynesian view about the relationship between output and unemployment. So let's start with the lecture. Students, according to Milton Friedman, the father of monetarist economist, in the long run, the influence of money is primarily on price level and other nominal variables, while real variables such as real output and employment level are determined by real factor. The natural rate of unemployment and output theory by Milton Friedman says that there exists an equilibrium level of output and an accompanying rate of unemployment determined by real factors or the supply side factors of production. These factors include technology and institutions of economy. Policies that cause a change in aggregate demand, such as monetary policy, causes temporary movements of economy from natural rate. Friedman defined natural rate of unemployment as the rate which has the property that it is consistent with equilibrium in structure of real wage rate. It is not possible for government to use monetary policy to maintain the economy permanently at the level of output above natural rate or at the unemployment rate below natural rate without accepting an ever accelerating rate of inflation. This position of monetarist economists is much similar to classical economists. However, Milton Friedman does not believe that economy is always at natural level of output and employment, at least in short run. According to them, the economy may deviate from natural level. Similar to Keynesian model, in Friedman's model, labor suppliers do not know the real wages exactly. The labor supply decisions are based on expected real wage. And in short run, expected price level may not be equal to actual price level. Therefore, unemployment and output will not be at their natural rates. To see why Milton Friedman believes that output and employment diverge from their natural rates temporarily, but will eventually be drawn to these rates, we examine Friedman's analysis of short-run and long-run consequences of an increase in the rate of growth of money supply. So first, money supply in the short run. Let's assume that an economy is where the output level is at its natural rate. Also suppose that the growth rate in money supply is equal to the growth rate in output, and therefore the price level is stable for the time period. Now assume that monetary authorities increase the money supply such that the growth rate in money supply is greater than the growth rate in real output of the economy. Therefore, the growth rate in money supply is increased above the rate consistent with price stability. This increase in growth rate of money supply will stimulate aggregate demand, and as a consequence, the nominal income will also increase. In short run, the increase in aggregate demand will lead to an increase in price level. However, since wages are constant because of future contracts, this will result in fall of real wages. However, increase in aggregate demand will lead to increase in labor demand and hence in nominal wages. Since the expectations of labor suppliers are at previous level, therefore, increase in nominal wages will lead to an increase in labor supply. Because of ex ante or expected real wage is higher, although the ex post or the actual real wage rate may be lower. Consequently, unemployment can be pushed below the natural rate. Precisely, this is what Phillips curve shows, that is the negative relationship between unemployment and inflation. Now, the monetary policy in long run. This situation described earlier will be temporary, as workers will eventually observe the higher price level and demand for higher monetary wages. This will restore real wages to equilibrium level, where labor market will be in equilibrium and the expected price level will be equal to actual price level. This rise in wages will cause employment to return at its natural rate. Suppose that an economy's equilibrium level, suppose that an economy's level of employment is at point A. Because of increase in money supply, aggregate demand increases, and so does the labor demand. This is represented by the movement from A to B. Here, unemployment is below the natural rate. Now, after some times, the worker will revise their expectations about prices, which will result in movement from Phillips curve 1 to Phillips curve 2. They will ask for higher monetary wages. Thus, at point C, the actual real wage rate will be same as it was at point A, and employment level will be back to natural rate. So, we conclude that Milton Friedman believed that downward sloping short-run Phillips curve are drawn for given expected inflation rate, whereas the long-run Phillips curve shows the relationship between inflation and unemployment when expected inflation has time to adjust to actual inflation rate. That is, when inflation is fully anticipated. Therefore, the long-run Phillips curve is vertical, showing no trade-off between unemployment and inflation in long run. An expansionary monetary policy can only temporarily move unemployment rate below natural rate, because the trade-off between unemployment and inflation is only in short run. If policy makers want to keep unemployment below natural level for a long time, they will have to keep on increasing money supply. Similarly, to control inflation, money supply will has to be decreased. However, it will take time to lower the inflation, and during that process, the economy may suffer from high inflation and high unemployment. Now that we have studied Milton Friedman's theory of natural rate of unemployment in both short as well as in long run, the question before us is, what is Keynesian view of Phillips curve and how does it differ from natural rate view of Friedman? The Keynesian models also employ a long run vertical long run Phillips curve. However, these models draw different policy conclusions than those drawn by monetarists. In Keynesian system, both monetary as well as fiscal policy actions may be used for an expansionary aggregate demand policy. In either case, the policy will produce a series of shifts in aggregate demand schedule. This will result in an increase in output. This will lead to an increase in price level and labor demand as well. So, the unemployment level will decrease and monetary wages will increase. Therefore, an expansionary monetary policy or an expansionary fiscal policy will result in increasing the employment level or decreasing the unemployment level. Until now, we kept expected price level as constant. Keynesian view that expected price level depends mainly on past behavior of prices. Therefore, an increase in actual price level in successive periods will lead to a rise in expected price level as well. In long run, the expected price level adjusts to actual price level. In Keynesian system, the labor supply depends on expected real wage rate as we studied in monetarist views. As the expected price rises, less labor will be supplied at any nominal wage rate because of fall in expected real wages. The increase in expected price also lowers output supplied at any price level. The labor supply and the aggregate supply schedules continue to shift left until prices are equal to expected price level. Therefore, an increase in aggregate demand increases output and lowers unemployment only in short run. The long run Phillips curve is vertical in Keynesian as well as in Friedman's view. Now we compare the views of monetarists and Keynesian. According to monetarists, the private sector is stable if left to itself. Thus, large destabilizing shocks to private sector demand for output are unexpected. Even if such shifts in private sector demand occurred, they would have little effect on output if money supply were held constant. Small shocks may cause output and employment to deviate somewhat from natural rate, but these shocks are unpredictable. Therefore, no policy can be designed to offset them. In short run, monetary policy could be used to bring unemployment and output at desired level. However, this will destabilize the economy as well. The Keynesian, on the other hand, believe that private sector aggregate demand is unstable as well. This is primarily because of instability of investment demand. Therefore, even for a given money supply, changes in private sector aggregate demand can cause large and prolonged fluctuations in income. Monetary and fiscal both policies should be used to offset such undesirable changes in aggregate demand and to stabilize the income. Now, we study the determinants of natural rate of unemployment. Students, the natural rate of unemployment, which is the rate determined by the market forces of labor demand and labor supply, will be affected by the structural characteristics of labor and commodity markets. These include market imperfections, stochastic variability in demands and supplies, cost of gathering information about vacancies and labor availabilities, the cost of mobility, etc. For example, low labor mobility in a country will lead to higher natural rate of unemployment, because as demand shifts from one region of country to another, workers would not be quick to follow. Similarly, poor information about job vacancies might also lead to a higher natural rate of unemployment, as workers will take long time to find jobs or to move between jobs. Therefore, the natural rate in each country will be determined by structural characteristics of that country's commodity and labor markets. Moreover, it will be time varying as well. That's all for today's lecture. Please give your feedback in comments. Also consider liking the video and subscribing the channel. Thank you and goodbye.